Hello and welcome to our November video. We're down here at the wharf just off Sitra, and I'm going to take this opportunity in November to talk a little bit about the environment. Before I do that, I want to give you an update on some of the things I talked about in the October video, mostly about the Bapco modernization program. I'm pleased to be able to tell you that on the 14th of October, we shared our plans again with the board, and they have endorsed our plan to go forward into phase two. This is great news for the project. The phase two is, again, like phase one, it's decision-based, so there is no time limit on it, but I would expect this to be complete in March or April of next year, and that's when we will start the clock ticking on our program going forward. So I look forward to be able to coming back in March or April and giving you an update on that. But to the subject of the environment, we're out here in this beautiful location. Bahrain is famous for the quality of its water, and of course I don't have to tell you about pearl fishing or anything like that. But the environment isn't only the marine environment. We need to talk about the land, about air, about some other things you mightn't consider to be environmental, but noise pollution is a big issue, and visual impact is another thing that we need to be very mindful of. It's not easy operating a business like this in this beautiful location, but we've been doing it for 80 years. Now, for the last 30 years, we've been working with a university in Sweden, and they come here every 2 years and make a survey of the marine environment, and they reported back to us last month in October about the progress we're making. And I'm very, very pleased to be able to tell you that we do continue to make very significant progress in the way that we are treating and rehabilitating the environment here. It's good news for all of us, for everyone here in Bahrain. So 30 years of continuous improvement is going a long way to reinforcing our commitment to the environment. In the last 6 or 7 years, Bapco has spent in excess of $400 million in improving the environment. That means not a penny of that has gone towards our bottom line. And our latest project will be the commissioning of the wastewater treatment plant at the end of this year, and that again will make a significant contribution towards the quality of the water in here. So all good news. We continue to work with the local universities, and we will continue to work with the university in Sweden to continue that progress. Unfortunately, a couple of things aren't particularly working in our favor. The reclamation work doesn't do much for the turbidity of the water here, and that has a deleterious effect. And perhaps overfishing as well is something. But neither of those things are anything that we can do much about. So let's just continue with our progress as it is. There is no one thing which we can do which will improve the environment. It's always a combination of things. I am reminded of the tremendous progress that we've made in our vehicle and our road safety management. You know that we have reduced, I was looking at the September figures, we managed to reduce our accident rate by 80%. I mean, that's really astonishing. That is an astonishing figure. And when I announced that I wanted a reduction in 90%, about a year ago, no one believed me, but we've made a reduction of 80%. And that's been through a combination of things. It's been through the introduction of the point system, of the police helping us at the Alba roundabout, with our safety stand downs, with flexi time, and with people taking personal responsibility for their own actions. And that brings me back again to the matter of the environment. The environment will only be improved by the people of Bapco setting a personal example to the rest of the nation and how we need to go forward. Personal responsibility is the thing that will make the big difference. And whether you work in finance and IT or in gas distribution network or operations, marketing here behind us, the wharf, HR, wherever it is only by taking that personal responsibility and personal accountability that we are, each of us, going to make the big change. About 2,600 years ago, a famous Greek physician called Hippocrates wrote out a list of things that physicians should do. And the first thing he said is that you should do no harm. And that's what I'm telling the people of Bapco. If we want to make an improvement in the environment, the first thing amongst many that we have to do is to do no harm. So this is my plea to everyone in Bapco who is setting an example for the rest of the nation. Do no harm. It's as simple as that. There are many other things that we have to do as we go forward into the modernization plan, and we will be spending a great deal of money in improving the environment and improving energy efficiency. But the first thing everyone has to internalize is that our duty with respect to the environment is that single phrase, do no harm. Thanks very much for your attention.